has been a week since Kenyan soldiers who were part of the African Union mission in Somalia were killed in a well-orchestrated attack by the Al-Shabaab militants in Somalia.
Each of the VBIDs used in the incident had a force equivalent to the terrorist attack on the embassy in Nairobi in 1998, or the VBID attack in Jazeera Palace Hotel in Mogadishu on 1st November 2015.
The Kenyan government has not come out to give the exact number of soldiers who were killed in El Ade camp in Somalia.
There will be the dead. There will be the missing. Okay? We have not finalized this operation. We are still ongoing, and that is why I say it and I plead again with you. We will tell you the figures as we go along. Let us finish this exercise and we will come back to you with time and let you know all the details.
The Kenyan Chief of Defense Forces, General Mwadede, has asked the affected families to come out and help the government piece together the number of the missing soldiers in Somalia. Following reports that something could have gone amiss at the El Ade camp in Somalia, General Mwadede has, however, promised to form a committee to investigate what clearly transpired leading to such a colossal amount of Kenyan soldiers who were part of the AU mission in Somalia.
I have sent a board of inquiry, which is at the moment in El Ade. That is the work of that board. Once that board is complete, it will give me the figures. I will let those figures be given to clients.
Well, about the casualties, I think in as much as we need to find out how many people were lost, we should give them time also, because it's a complicated situation. So we need to give them time to, you know, to try and find out exactly where, if others lost their lives and the ones who are missing, whether they're being held or they're somewhere in Somalia, maybe trying to find their way home.
The Al-Shabaab militants allege that they have relocated dozens of Kenyan soldiers they captured in the El Ade camp from Juba to an unknown place in Mogadishu, Somalia. All this mess started 5 years ago when the Kenyan government decided to send its troops to Somalia to help that government pursue the Al-Shabaab terror movement, which is linked to the Al-Qaeda terror network. Al-Shabaab then was working so hard to destabilize the Somali government, which is in the Horn of Africa.
As citizens and even the families of the people who died in last week in Somalia, we don't have the full information. We don't know what happened. We don't know the number of casualties. Their families were trying to get that information. They can't get it. So we're asking the government, can we get the truth? Just tell us what happened in Somalia, because we need to learn those lessons. But at the same time, we're saying thank you, the Kenya Defense Forces, thank you for the people who died in Somalia, because they gave their life. And that's like the highest sacrifice any person can ever do.
All this is happening at a time when a somber mood has engulfed affected families, some of whom do not yet know the fate of their beloved ones. Johanna Chacha, NewTR, Nairobi, Kenya.